My girl's been trying to like get a little set up to like record music and stuff.
Yeah.
And she's back in that thing where it's like anytime you look up how to set up a podcast, they skip all the important stuff.
Yeah.
Like be here, good. You want to get this microphone?
First step, try and be
content
funny.
Content-wise,
yeah. First step, don't.
Yeah, let's see if you really want to do this.
Yeah.
Ask your friends if you're funny.
I tell you that my buddy was saying there was like an apartment building that just opened up by him.
Yeah.
And like part of the amenities for the apartment building is a podcast room.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Is it its own or it's like shared with the whole apartment?
It's the whole complex. Shared with the whole building.
Like a
yeah.
podcast That's simulator?
It. No, it's like for
you
people
can
that want. Yeah, it's like we got a weight room and a pool. And
That's
a
fucking. I would never
podcast
live there.
Podcast room.
That's the biggest red flag you could get.
Yeah.
I'd rather have a pedophile rink.
A pedophile rink?
Yeah, you skate around. You get to chase little kids, the one you want. You pick them out like a hunter. Hello, kid's got natural red hair. I'm going to get this.
That sounds expensive.
Well, that's my point. You gotta make some money.
That's the lengths you'll go to avoid being around.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
And there's people just walking by that going, you know, I always thought I should be a podcaster. And they call their wife in. They're like, let's start one. Let's do one on Polynesian art.
That actually sounds pretty interesting.
Damn.
Pick
the wrong example.
I blame Seinfeld for the start of dudes thinking that just their conversations are interesting enough.
Yeah. Yeah.
For it to be content.
Yeah.
Seinfeld.
It's Larry David's fault.
Yeah.
Isn't it? Ultimately?
They're the first ones that are just like, just dudes talking, just hanging out.
Yeah. Wasn't Larry David?
Is that your first reaction to Seinfeld? Is like, they're way too fucking casual. These guys are way too laid back.
But it is true.
Where's
though?
The editing on this? Yeah. I need to cut out
That's
the fat.
Totally something she would say. That's crazy. It is fucking annoying, though. You know? At least what? There's a setting in something else, like Cheers, you know? Obviously, yeah. It's comfortable. You think they're saying natural stuff, which they are. They do it well. But there's something about the apartment that fires me the fuck up.
As a,
that pisses really? You the fuck
yeah,
off?
He's got a good point. I'm fucking upset about it now.
You guys don't like Seinfeld?
No.
No, dude.
I actually never did. This is true. I never watched Seinfeld.
You've never seen it?
I've seen, like, when I watch it, I'm like, yeah, I don't know. It's too...
Yeah.
Don't do it,
Tom. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It
no,
is.
It's just so far removed from my upbringing and people that I am entertained by, like Wonder Years, Cheers, All in the Family, all those sitcoms that are just like truly hardcore.
But it's
not
new,
like goofy.
But it's New York. You love New York.
Yeah, right. And and it was when I had no idea about New York.
I mean, I get
the
not
subtle humor. I didn't fucking.
I get not liking the every single member of the cast, but the show's good.
Yeah, yeah. I can't deny that it's not entertaining to a certain extent. I just couldn't fully commit. You know, yeah. I wanted to see Mr. Arnold get fucking angry at his kids because he's a drunk and angry and hates his job. He's a Vietnam vet. I want to see him get very close to beating his fucking kid because that's my love language.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, we don't have any good child beating shows anymore.
Not anymore, baby.
No,
we're coming back.
Euphoria is close.
Yeah,
I haven't watched it.
Those are children beating children.
I was
going to
say, isn't that just like hot transsexuals rubbing genitals on each other?
That's what the internet's told me.
Yeah, but yeah. I haven't seen the whole thing, but I've seen some clips a lot.
Yeah, it is porn. It's just fucking young porn.
Yeah.
We didn't
I don't
have
know.
That.
I bet if you watch it, there's some compelling storylines.
Yeah.
There is. I've actually seen the whole thing. It's great. the whole thing's great. Yeah. It's really it's well really done. Good. Yeah. It's really well shot, really well written. The music's great. The acting's great. And you see amazing boobies. What more could you want?
I'm starting to understand the hate of Seinfeld.
Yeah, well, Elaine can get it.
Yeah, not enough fucking tits.
Elaine, she's hot. Yeah. She's still aging well.
Yeah, I like her more in her good. Veep days.
Yeah, even that. Yeah. God.
I want to put a peep in Veep.
Let's go, dude. There you go. You're on fire now, baby. You think we need prep for this shit? We do fucking not.
I had peep in Veep locked in the chamber already.
You
That's
fucking
the one
hack,
thing you
dude.
Prepared.
You
prepared for the show.
It's going to come out. It's going to come out.
Yeah.
If not, I'll bring it up.
There's a couple things that I'm trying to steer the conversation to so I have something locked and loaded.
Safety net. Yeah. I understand.
Yeah.
But yeah, you got to respect a show like Seinfeld that like every day, you know, tires like that. As long as there's just brilliance behind the whole mechanism. You got great writers, great actors, comedic actors, and you just go, this can go for 20 seasons if you want.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it was good.
I've talked to you about
made it to nine, and I think it. Yeah,
I've talked to you about
because everyone's like, "Fuck this!"
Yeah,
every time like Tires comes up around you, you seem like so bummed about it.
Yeah,
you seem so sad.
Dude, he's a fucking curmudgeon. I haven't seen his unless he's going fishing. I've never seen his eyebrows go up.
I never know what to say about it, and it's like anything else. You feel like self conscious. It's like after a set, even if it goes well, and someone's like, "That was great," you're like, "Thanks, man."
You look at your shoes.
Yeah, yeah. Thank
you. Go drink a bottle of liquor.
Yeah. I hope you're not lying to me. So bad. Yeah.
Yeah, you don't believe it whenever they say enjoyed something.
Yeah.
The worst is when you actually objectively have a great set and somebody that bombs all the time is like, good set. Like, was it good? I've never seen you once have a good set.
Yeah.
Literally, get on your fucking knees and blow me.
It does. It gives me anxiety when someone bombs and you go, how did it go? And they go, it was awesome.
Decent.
Yeah, they were great.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you're like, I saw it.
Yeah, I was there.
Yeah. Can't we both have a moment where we go, that sucked for both of us?
Yeah. I was both pissed and glad you guys left the show we were on a few nights ago. Mm-hmm. It was a...
Yeah, I definitely didn't see that.
Yeah. You probably heard it because everybody shut the fuck up. You probably heard my voice echoing down 6th Street. Shit, Tommy's still on. Hold on. As soon as everybody gets to a red light, you can hear me echoing.
Do that, yeah.
Fuck that place. I mean, that's a great place.
Chris, you had a great set.
Yeah. That was one of those sets.
Very good crowd. Very good crowd. Very giving, too, with a lot of the stuff that wouldn't normally work. They're very giving.
Yeah. Dude. It's also when you see someone have a good set ahead of you that you know is not a good comic, you're like, this could be one of two things. The greatest night because they're laughing at everything.
Yeah.
Or if they like that, they're going to fucking hate me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it was the opposite.
That's a real humbling moment when you're like, well, this guy's killing. I'm going to crush.
Yeah.
Just eat shit.
Fucking crickets.
Yeah, like, I'm going to run home as fast as I can. Dude.
You should have seen me barrel chested, waving my arms, going through the little crowd area to get out of there.
Oh, my God.
Didn't even get a chance to tip the bartender. Just power walk to like the corner.
And you would have too.
Uh-huh. That's why. Sorry, bombed. Yeah. Just getting picked up by a fucking Lyft. She was a yappy broad. Chris, this is crazy. White Claw Zero is nuts.
That's insane.
I've been doing it, man.
No, I'm proud of you. But
it's
like,
a trick.
The trick is for beer bottles or actual bubbly beers.
No, but I've drank enough White Claws in my life that this has the same feel to it.
Is it the can size?
It's the width.
Because
no one
drinks a White Claw and is like, man, this is so good.
No, but
I'll have it 0% alcohol.
Yeah,
it's just a fucking seltzer.
No, it is. It's totally a seltzer. But if I was, I've tried to drink a regular seltzer before in place of this. Not the same. Yeah, I can only have one.
The can size.
Yeah, I could put down 15 of these.
That's terrible.
Yeah, it's bad for me for sure. It's got to be.
What's going on with your gut? You doing a lot of tooting?
No. Just classic morning farts.
Yeah, I only fart in the morning.
Yeah.
Unless I have, you know, some wild lasagna at a comedy club. I only toot
lasagna
in the morning.
Lasagna at a comedy club?
I'm just saying. You made a wrong food choice somewhere.
Change your decision.
Yeah, I feel like it's your digestive tract shifting the process of your load. Yeah,
I don't know. Something's going on. But in the morning, it's crazy how big they are.
Yeah. Isn't it fun?
Yeah.
What's the last time you shit yourself?
Feel guilty. It's been a while. I feel like it was not as long ago as I would have hoped, but
you're smiling a little more talking about this than talking about tires. That's crazy.
Yeah. This I know how to talk about. Yeah. I would much rather talk about shitting my pants than something that's going really well in my life.
Yeah.
Dude, speaking of going terrible in my life.
What?
Are we talking about getting a dog? I'm sweating my ass off.
You had a girlfriend already.
You know, this fucking guy. Get the bell. Honey? We got a ringer for every ringer. We go to this SBCA or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Down here. Animals Alive.
SACA.
Austin Rescue Alive. I don't know what the fuck it is. So my girl's having a bad day, and she's like, let's do something fun. She's like all depressed and angry and just in a funk. And she's like, we talked about getting a dog. Why don't we just go look at some rescue dogs?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, that's going to be uplifting, right? Mm-hmm. And then we went to this dog prison.
Yeah, no.
Dude, I've never been.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You check in, you wait, and you just watch, like, one of the handlers will walk by a series of cages.
Yep.
And then it's just a bunch of dogs like, no,
yeah,
no,
yeah,
fuck.
Yeah, yeah. Please get us out of here. It's like going to the zoo. You ever go to the zoo?
Yeah, I love the zoo.
When's the last time you went?
Have they changed?
No, just no, you've changed.
That's true. Dude, that's like going to Barnum and Bailey Circus. Yeah. You're like, these elephants are fucking creative.
Yeah, when you're seven. Yeah. And then you go back and you're like, this is fucked.
Yeah, man. Then you see an Indian dude with a 12-foot stick beating the fuck out of their ass.
Yeah. Dude, that's what it's like. You look at polar bears or cheetahs or anything.
Yeah, they're all so tired all the time.
Like, oh, man.
Yeah. They're just looking for exits. Sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just literally sitting in the shade on a hot day being like, fuck.
Yeah.
It's look like, yeah, it's horrible. Well, and they can't run, especially cheetahs. They can't build a place big enough for them to run.
Yeah, it's solitary confinement.
Yeah, you get a nice break with the giraffes. You get to feed them lettuce. That's a nice moment.
We're talking,
and then it's back.
It's not
to
a break
horse.
For the animals. What we're talking about. You're finally getting a nice break. I got a pop of endorphins when I fed the giraffes some grass.
And the giraffes are choosing to be there because they're so tall they could escape.
Yeah,
at
yeah.
Any
they
point.
Could get
what
out.
Is so the best animal? The happiest animal in a zoo? You think?
Probably the people
the
paying for the tickets.
True.
Yeah.
The snakes.
Yeah.
Yeah. They don't even know where they're at.
They're fine.
Yeah.
Right? The reptile section's fine.
The penguins look like they're having fun.
Yeah, the penguins seem
they got
right.
A nice little cooler that they're swimming around in.
Yeah.
I love how Chris says penguin.
Penguin?
Penguin.
Penguin?
Yeah. Penguin.
Says it like a fat black lady. He says it on stage and I crack up every time.
Penguin.
Penguin. Yeah. You talk about penguins a lot?
Penguins, yeah, a little bit.
He's got a penguin joke.
Yeah, I got a penguin joke. Yeah, there are. There's words that I say that I'm not really sure where they came from.
It's Connecticut. It's a hodgepodge of everywhere.
It's a New York, bastardized New York.
Yeah.
Yeah. Connecticut hybrid.
You're too close to Boston, who fucks everything up.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you say the bagel?
Bagel.
Yeah, I say bagel.
Where I'm from in East Tennessee, we would call them Jew holes.
start the podcast there. That's where we start. Finally. Jesus Christ. I avoided the whole Seinfeld conversation. Yeah. I was holding back for no reason. What a fucking waste. Let's get going, man. I'm out of my sorts. I'm podcast weak right now.
That's Seinfeld looking at the demographics. Yeah. There's a Jew hole in East Tennessee. Nobody's watching this.
Let me get a Jew hole toasted with chive cream cheese.
You spotted a bit of a Jew hole in.
I should try that.
What?
Speaking of, I will say, all right, look, it's not racist.
Okay.
Anti-Semitic. The new Hitler doc. Around the Nuremberg trials is fucking impeccable.
What do you like about it?
Every year, just for clicks, they recreate something around World War II. Hitler is enamoring to many people. Just the fascination around what transpired in the world. Obviously.
Yeah.
You can't do that every year or two. It's just like it's too overexposed. By this point, if you're interested, you know everything. You can't show me anything I haven't already seen. Their first attempt at that was World War II in color. Everyone's like, let's go.
Yeah, that was
I'll
great.
Rewatch everything I already know.
Yeah.
What could they possibly do? We know about the trials. In this case, they spliced the trials and then did back lookbacks at the actual war footage. And it was newer footage that I hadn't seen.
Yeah.
And they went through the voice of the journalist from the Washington Post or New York Times, that was on site following them and reporting. Actually,
the Nuremberg
on site.
Trials?
No.
Oh.
The war.
Oh,
so he got to know Hitler, he got to know Churchill, he got to know all these people, and he started getting like death threats and all that stuff. So they kept going back and forth from footage to the trials to this guy's reports and his diaries, thinking he was just going to get fucking offed. And it's great. And it's like,
so this guy was like just following Hitler around, like interviewing him while he's
trying to interview him and also reporting on his speeches and like what was happening in the crowds. And he was just an insider look. It was almost like spy, but he wasn't a spy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's just there with a, yeah.
Yeah, and he got like kidnapped at one point, and they were like, you can't write this. You have to write it as in everything's fine. This is, you know, our,
yeah, yeah,
our objective.
Censoring his material.
Yeah. It's like, lose all your sense of true journalism. And then he tried to not do that, and then he had to go in like hiding in a way.
Did he have a secret notebook where he was going to write a book?
Yeah, he had a secret diary, which was all the journaling.
The end of the war?
Yeah, which he hid, which is awesome. You don't see that kind of shit.
Yeah, yeah. That's crazy.
So skip Seinfeld, watch the fucking Nuremberg Trials on Netflix.
I like the idea of him having a diary. Did he put like who he had a crush on in there too?
There was every other page. He just wrote that like Stussy S. Was it Stussy? What was the S? Do you remember the S?
No. What is, oh, that like fucking
line.
I feel like
the
it
cool
is.
S, the really cool one.
Yeah. Come on.
It would be funny if you have that. You'd have to take a break. I bet he fucked a bunch of Nazis while he was over there.
The German women are okay, I guess. Some of them.
Yeah. I think they're hot.
Yeah, they can bake bread and stuff. And
yeah. What?
Your housewives. Right? Yeah, they're proper housewives.
Yeah.
Everyone, is that a
Yeah, and then there's the Berlin ones that are just men and they spank you and shit.
Yeah, what is their crazy sexual thing over there?
Germans?
Yeah,
yeah. Well, I think they because they're so ashamed and oppressed for years that they're like, we have to do the exact opposite of everything.
Yeah,
so we have to go completely the other way and let's just start fucking everyone and everything.
Do you think that's the case?
Yeah, with the Berlin Wall coming down, I think that's when everyone started doing anal.
All the hots were on the one side.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah.
And all the whips and belts were on the other side.
Yeah, you had to combine
two. And they came together.
Yeah. Yeah, they already...
yeah.
Finally, my hand's been dislocated.
A divided nation, yeah. It's a lot of effort, whips and belts.
Yeah. Yeah, you got to plan.
Yeah.
Takes out the spontaneity.
I can tell. I'm going to tell this story. I shouldn't tell this story, but I'm going to tell the story without telling the guy's name. A buddy of ours used to take a pontoon boat from New Hampshire to an island, and he was dating this old lady who was a doctor. And the first night he got there, and she started saying some weird shit about like belts and stuff, and he thought it was just like a joke. And then I guess they had sex, and then he took a pontoon boat out there the next night. And he got in the bedroom. There was just a belt on the bed. It was laid out.
He completely misses. Are you cheating on me?
Is Walter here?
On this, how many other people on this fucking island?
Where are his shoes? So he kind of gets like, oh. And then they start like using the belt. And he's like smacking her ass. And she's like harder, and it's like that. Have you ever been in that scenario where it's like, no,
this
is fucking weird, you know?
Yeah.
It got to the point where she could only come if he would whip her pussy. Dude, so she's on all fours, and he has to come like at a weird angle.
What are the
to whip her pussy? To
what
come.
are the races of these two people?
She was white.
And what was
he's white.
Whoa.
They're in New Hampshire. Dude, blacks aren't allowed in New Hampshire.
That's the weirdest part of the story. You tell me two white people were fucking?
Yeah.
On an island?
Yeah, that's how you make more New Hampshire. That's how you double New Hampshire. You beat a white bitch with a belt in her pussy.
Just a kid pops out?
I shouldn't have said that, but yeah, that's how she got off. We've talked about this. Thank God I don't have a thing.
Yeah.
But if she has to go on like Bumble and slowly integrate the pussy whip and belt.
Yeah. Well, there's other apps where you can put exactly what you're into sexually.
No shit.
And then you match up. You're like, I am into getting my pussy whipped. And then there's other people that are into whipping pussy. And then you match with
what
those people.
What app is this?
All right, guys, you know it. You love it. This episode is brought to you by Squarespace.com. If you're starting a website, this is the best way to do it. They've got everything you need. They got the Fluid Engine. They've got Blueprint AI and SEO tools, flexible payments. The Squarespace AI Kickstarter update when written content on any website, product description, or email with Squarespace AI, generating instant personalized results that you know and show your brand identity. Explain what your site is about, choose your tone, and enter what you need to get short or long form text, no matter what the placement is. Squarespace AI makes it easier to live, stand out, and succeed online. You can also sell exclusive content on your site by adding a paywall to sell memberships or courses, or sell files your customers can download, like PDFs, music, or ebooks. There's also, you can upload video content, organize your video library, and showcase your content on beautiful video pages. You can even sell access to your video library by adding a paywall to your content. That's pretty wild.
A friend of mine texted me out of nowhere asking, I don't know why she asked. She listened to our podcast, but randomly was like, I'm starting a website for my business. Like, just out of nowhere. And I was like, use Squarespace code, yeah. Stuff Island. You can get, I think it's 15%
off. 10% off the purchase of a domain or website.
Yeah. That's what she did.
Is that what we're, yeah. Go to squarespace.com/Stuff Island to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain using code Stuff Island. Squarespace.com/Stuff Island or use the code Stuff Island. Come on.
Chris, are you ready to be the hottest dude in our crew? You know, most of us.
All you need is a new black t-shirt. Yeah, dude. Actually, the material looks sick, dude. It's crazy. Nice. You know what it is? It's good travel wear, in my opinion.
It is good travel wear.
Because it looks good, and it's light, and it's breathable.
Holy shit. Are you doing this read or mine? It's incredible.
I wore it on a flight recently, and I was like, this is perfect.
It feels like PJs, but looks like dress up.
Yes.
And that's what all of our friends really try to do.
Yeah.
Because all of us just wear t-shirts all day long, you know? And this gives you a nice kind of a designer look with comfort of PJs.
Yeah.
It's wrinkle-free, which is fucking nuts. And that's why it's great for travel as well. I don't know if we have the joggers from them. I know we have jeans that are crazy
comfortable.
The jeans
are nice, yeah.
But this is Cuts. This episode's also brought to you by Cuts. C-U-T-S.
Go to cutsclothing.com.
Yeah. Code word Stuff Island, you get 20% off. So if you want to be relaxed at a date and not look like you're that relaxed, look like you're dressed up, you want to be the hot one in your crew, like Chris, just go to cutsclothing.com, put in the code Stuff Island, you get 20% off your order, which is crazy. You know, you can obviously see I look pretty good in this.
Dude, I want to get some of their stretch to fit joggers.
That's the flight. That's the total flight fit.
Yes. Yeah. The perfect flight outfit.
Black on black.
Yep.
Sleek looking.
Yep.
Dude, it's, you feel this.
No,
it's
I know.
It's like silky, stretchy, and it's wrinkle free.
Guys.
This is my second shirt out of the packaging. You can't even tell.
Yeah. Cutsclothing.com. Use code Stuff Island. 20% off. It's Michael Chandler's favorite clothing company.
Oh, Michael Chandler.
Yeah.
MMA Michael Chandler?
Yeah, he put me in an armbar at the Beer Olympics.
I saw that. Yeah, yeah. You were just getting fucked up by Michael Chandler.
Yeah, I know.
3 days ago.
I should have talked to him about cuts. Yeah. Maybe he would have laid off.
I'm going to blow my rotator cuff. Cuts rules.
Cuts save me.
I'm just asking for the guy.
There's one called Field that I've been on, and it's all ugly polyamorous people. Yeah, yeah. All horrific.
That's okay.
Looking.
Well, it depends on what are you into.
I'm into like vagina, and I really like, my kink is when I get to put my penis inside of one.
Why are you doing Field?
Because a friend was doing it, and she's a woman, so she was having great success on there.
Yeah,
and then I tried it and had zero success.
Yeah,
I went on one date with a woman who was in a polyamorous relationship, and. it turned out that her boyfriend knew me and was like a fan. So that was really strange. And then I was still like, well, whatever.
Yeah, yeah. I don't care. I'll deal with that later.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's so weird. I'm going to have to unpack that after we have sex.
Yeah.
That's the weirdest thing ever. But
my mental clarity is clear when my balls are empty. Yeah. So why don't we
So I'm then, sure future me will be able to handle it.
We never had sex. We were going to have a second date because we just got coffee the first one. We're going to go out as again. And then she canceled. She said that she was polysaturated at the moment and didn't want to go out.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
Wow.
Which means she's getting fucked too fucking hard.
Just using that language.
This is gross.
She's just having too much sex. She's a whore. Just say, sorry, I can't. My pussy's broke at the moment.
What's the same?
I'm being too much of a pig. Yeah. Because I'm not in love with my boyfriend and we refuse to break up.
Yeah.
Like, it'll never work. I refuse to believe this. And I'm not saying like 1950s Christian one man, one woman. I get it. But if your whole lifestyle is going on apps and feeding this machine because you can't connect with the individual next to you, mm-hmm. is fucked. I get like if you go to Greece, right? You see a hot bartender. She's always wanted to eat a bag. And you're like, all right, let's see what we can do. Let's
take a bag?
Fellatio.
What?
Eat a bag? That's the first time I've heard that one.
I eat a White Claw, dude. I'm fired up. You should try the ones that aren't zero, dude. You start saying stuff you never said before. But I'm saying, like, I'm not opposed to people just going, let's have a third in the bedroom, let's have some fun. But if that's your whole identity, then you're hiding.
You got to have a hobby. A hobby can't be fucking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You should be saturated from fucking.
Yes.
Yeah, you're an absolute piglet.
Yeah.
You need to be shot in a farm.
Well, the they want the same thing, like the idea of a fuckboy and someone who's polyamorous. They want the same thing, but the polyamorous person just has more verbiage on ways to say it to where it doesn't sound
whore-ish.
As egregious. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, and maintain a relationship with someone who's got a steady paycheck.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Which I feel like is a common thread.
Yeah.
Important.
And just what I've seen.
Yeah, and what I've seen, the common thread is eventually they go amok in the city. They eventually have a connection with somebody that's greater than the person they've started this relationship with, and they start clinging to them more, and then there's a fight there where they don't love that person because now they're jealous.
Yeah.
And it's like, what are you complaining about? You fucking made your bed. This is exactly what would happen. You think everybody's just as dunce as you? Mm-hmm. Just open... You know, as you get older, you realize it's not just genitals, man. There's a heart in there, too.
Their argument is that every relationship sucks. Mine just sucks in a different way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. And we have bonuses.
Which is not bad. That's a tough one to.
Well, it sucks, but you're allowed.
Can't bring that up. That must be the hardest start of a conversation. Look, we're going through it right now.
Yeah.
It's going to be tough. And I do love you. I think we should stick together. I got an idea. What if we just start exploring other things?
Yeah.
Other people. But we come home, we're safe, we wear condoms. Mm-hmm.
Let's not work out any of our problems.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's just go out into the world and ignore that. And then
you just sweat on a couple backs, get your load off, come home.
Yeah. I'm currently poly unsaturated.
Mono unsaturated.
I need to expand.
You just got to stay busy, man. You got to stay busy. Got to stay in the pocket.
Yeah, it really is a thing where that's mostly how I feel about it. I don't think it's wrong, but I feel like there's better ways to spend your time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
An inactive mind is the most dangerous fucking mind to me.
Yeah.
Like anytime I have days off or something. Yeah.
Remember the movie Idle Hands?
No, I remember the name. I don't remember the plot.
It was, yeah.
Is it four Jews in an apartment?
Are they all four Jews?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah, it was a very racist show. They wouldn't hire anyone that's not Jewish.
Yeah.
Even the writer's room.
No black is or white.
Well, that'd be great. Yeah, yeah. Every third episode, you know who wrote it. Kramer comes up like, yo, what's up, bitches?
I haven't seen many of those down here.
Black Israelites?
Yeah.
There's right outside Vulcan. They're there like every other week. Like,
talking about a barbecue spot.
You got it. I'll take you.
Try the honey butter. I'm telling you. It'll flip your wig.
Talk to Alfred. He'll help you out.
No, they are. I've seen them. Yeah. The purple and yellow.
Yeah. They're there like every other week. And because I do shows at Vulcan and they're always there like scaring away people that we're trying to sell tickets to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're always just real mad and They're very, it is very funny. Homophobic, very anti-gay, very anti-white.
Yeah.
So I look like both of those things. So.
What are they pro?
Themselves. Blacks.
Are they pro-Israel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they consider themselves the first Jews.
Yeah. But the Jews that are there now, they can't be thrilled about, right?
What do you mean, Chris?
I'm saying that they gotta hate Jews. Right? I just assumed.
Well, yeah, if it's a...
Like, I don't think they're going on Birthright and being like, everything's great here.
Yeah, it's like two... I feel like it's like two separate things. Like, two kings both calling themselves king.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mad at the other one.
Kangs.
Raising Kangs.
I'm the only Kang.
Yeah.
Wake up, white people. Dude, they are like... They're very funny. If you stick around... Just try not to lock eyes.
They soften up.
Because it's like looking at a brown bear protecting its cubs, dude. If one catches you staring and like mocking, you know, they fucking swarm like wasps.
Did they say stuff to you?
Yeah.
No. No, I was like this. Every time I looked at me, I was like,
ugh. Don't mess with that guy. He's about to pass out. It's such a have a heart attack.
No, there's like they block off 6th Street. And it's just all young kids dressed like hookers. And there's people calling. All the bars there are real shitty. They're open. No one's really in them. Everybody's barking to come into their bar. Mm-hmm. There's like, smoother Latin dudes approaching every hot girl.
Yeah.
You know, they're just running numbers, man. It's just like they're just hitting on women the whole fucking time. And then you have a whole pack of black Israelites reading the Old Testament, talking about how white people are the devil. And then you got to go do comedy.
Then you have the best comedy club in the world.
Yeah, exactly. It's such a wild... That 2-block radius of like getting dropped off and then walking through that, just the anxiety-ridden mayhem.
It is kind of... It's a nice melting pot.
It's a carnival.
Yeah.
It's a true fucking carnival. It's a circus. It's a human circus. And leaving that...
Could you take a pamphlet from a black Israelite?
No. They're not recruiting us. I looked into it.
Really?
No, there's no fucking way.
Why not?
Because you walk by them and they don't hand you a pamphlet. They stand tall, strict. They're all looking for fights, dude. They're crazy people.
Yeah.
That's what people said about Jesus.
Yeah, he was. He was a crazy homeless dude.
Hung out on 6th Street.
He had pretty good friends, though.
Oh, he's just good at speeches, like Hitler.
What else was Hitler good at?
I'm hoping like these pauses, you guys have something to say.
I kind of want to know if there was like, what was a new piece of information in the Hitler doc that you didn't know?
Before? I didn't know anything about this journalist following the war. Yeah. That's number one. The Nuremberg trials were black and white, and they didn't go through the individual, outside of just like running the lineup of like all their crimes. They got very specific into each one and how they tried to fight their case. So they would showcase one of the defendants and then they would go into the history books, find him on camera, find his speeches, find his books where he signs off on this shit while he's gone, I had nothing to do with this. I thought Hitler was going
just
to do this.
Following orders
kind
of thing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then someone would be like, I had to do what I had to do.
Yeah.
And out of like 128 defendants, I think like 80-something... Or one, I forget the numbers exactly, but over 2/3 were found guilty. And of those guilty, only like 2 or 3 of them got like small sentences.
Yeah.
And then the majority of that majority were hanged. Hanged. They were hunged.
They hung them.
Yeah, they hung them. And the cyanide capsules that all the other guys.
Wait, I thought they were white though.
Like Himmler. Himmler and that fat piece of shit, whatever his name is.
I want to be clear. I was making a penis joke. I was making a hung penis joke. I want the record to show. I was not making a lynching joke.
East Tennessee stuff over there.
I was making a penis joke.
But so a lot of them, they confiscated the pills into the prisons and ate the cyanide before they can get...
Tried.
No, after the trial, after they were convicted, before they got hung. They didn't want to be humiliated like Mussolini was. Mm. Yeah. How they hung him and his fucking wife.
Damn.
And then beat the shit out of them in the
I
streets.
I wish there was like a cyanide Narcan back then. That would have been such a bummer for them.
To bring them back to life?
Yeah, yeah. And have him come back and be like, no.
Yeah. And then they hang him. They hang him and then pick him up a little bit, like get his breath. Yeah. I would, why are there, outside of Abu Ghraib, which we didn't hide that well, we should have torture camps. Like really get into it. Mm. I would submit my resume. My resume.
Not concerned.
My resignation. Get the job. I'm going to fucking get out of it.
I'm
getting fired off.
I love that for you, just being in the CIA for 40 years and being like, where is the torturing? I was supposed to be.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are we trying to do, though? What information would we need now?
No, it's just more to
where
get off
certain
on.
Pokemon are and how to find them. Just one, some rogue.
Pokemon go to the polls.
I would feel bad for a guy. There had to be like a whole town in Germany that didn't even know the war was going on.
It's impossible. What do you mean?
I don't know. They could just be out in the mountains or the woods somewhere.
I doubt there was like Ted Kaczynski's in fucking 1935 Germany.
I bet there were. There had to be Germans that had no idea what was going on.
They just took a long 10-year nap.
No, and then all of a sudden the Russians just came through and
raped them.
Yeah. They were just hating the Jews by themselves, and they had no idea there was a whole club going on.
They missed out on all the fun. It was a nightmare scenario. And then,
missing the fun and then getting fucked.
It's like when you go to a small town and you see like a punk. Like a goth, you're like, you would kill it in New York. You had no idea what's going on.
What are you doing here, man?
Yeah, you're just suffering. Yeah. Just an army of one.
What the fuck is East Tennessee like? Martinelli's. This best apple juice. This is what I was talking about on set.
What's up?
No, you just said, I don't
Martinelli's was the guy who got hung and beaten to death.
But the Nuremberg trial?
Mm. Mussolini is what you
Mussolini, say. Mussolini, yeah. They're the same.
East Tennessee is fun. It's mountainous. I lived close to Dollywood. You know, Dolly Parton's amusement park.
Mm-hmm. That was an actual thing?
It's a real thing, yeah. Dolly Parton has an amusement park where everything is themed after her. And every month or so, she does a little carousel ride through the park. And everyone stops. And
is there any hidden imagery of her tits?
Well, it's not hidden. It's very open.
It's a big factor for Dolly.
Mm-hmm. Like the teacups go in just giant circles?
Yeah. They squirt.
Milk everywhere?
Yeah.
You seen her recently? She's holding up for 85 for whatever she is.
Mm-hmm. I bet she's 97.
It's a lot of surgery, I imagine.
Yeah. I think they keep getting bigger, too.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Were you shooting guns and stuff?
No, I was raised in the suburbs, so we were... Very no guns in the home. Christian household, though.
Okay.
And then my dad went completely. He's an atheist now and an ally. I think he became an ally because he thought that I was gay. Like, truly, I really do think that.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn.
Wait, so you guys didn't talk for a while? He lost his faith and then was like, son. Now I get what you've been doing. I think we should be closer.
I like the idea that just that he's thinking you're gay and he's like asking him all these questions, like himself, all these questions about like, my son's gay. I'm super Christian. I got to change. I got to grow. I'm like, I love my son. I can't like abandon him. He's like really going through it.
Yeah. So he does
and
the research.
Turns out you're just fucking chicks the whole time.
Well, it's confusing for him because the girls I would bring home are like these shaved head, hairy armpit girls. And he's like, we're getting closer.
Yeah.
We need you to bring home a real man.
That would be fun.
Don't toy with me. Just rip the band-aid off.
These half-breeds aren't going to do it. That's so funny. Hurt. Him losing his faith to get closer with his son only to find out his son's not gay.
Yeah, and come back to Christ.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you guys talk?
Yeah, we talk. They're good. My parents are still together. They're very supportive of things that I do.
How Christian are we talking? How Christian was your upbringing?
He once smacked me because I said, holy crap.
Oh my God. You guys would go to church every Sunday?
Every Sunday, or twice Sunday, once Wednesday.
Did he wind up while you were saying holy, and then he hit you before the crap came
out?
Well,
there's a little smile when I said holy, and then the crap came. He's like, wait, what?
Yeah, but he was already...
He thought I was just going to say, like, holy father, I love
wait,
thee.
Wait, this is... Hold on a second. Hold on. Twice in one on day? Man.
Church, yeah, so early, the Sunday morning and then Sunday evening.
Why? What'd you learn?
I learned that I didn't want to be there, that's for sure.
That's fucking insane.
You get like 4 hours between off. You go home and you eat, you go to La Carreta or a Mexican restaurant and get chips and queso. And I would get they have a Mexican hamburger, which is ground up meat. And queso on a bun. But I would get it with no meat, so it's just queso
bun. Bun, queso, bun? Take me to church 3 times before eating that, dude. That's crazy.
That was the first time. That was when his dad started to crumble.
Yeah. It's not working.
He's eating a cheese sandwich. Yeah.
And in the morning, we'd have those glazed U holes.
Yeah.
And... That was the best part, was just getting donuts in the morning.
Did they make callbacks for the morning mass? Like, what was the second mass? Was it just the same as the...
It was the same
one?
Thing. There was less people because you could see who was committed or not.
So it's all pride. Your parents wanted the other community members to see that you guys were committed.
It was an endurance run.
You're the top 1%.
Yeah. And then Wednesdays was for youth group.
God, okay. This is so sad. What a waste of youth.
Did that drive you crazy?
It was just kind of what we did. I didn't...
You didn't want to like stay home and watch something else?
All the time. Yeah. All the time, but it wasn't really an option.
I went to 12 years of Catholic school. My dad never went to church once.
Wow.
Unless it was a funeral for a very close loved one, he'd sit in there for a minute. And my mom always just pushed it off like, yeah, your dad, he's spiritual in his own way. And
we went to church every Sunday for the first maybe 7 or 8 years of my life.
Yeah. Dude, I used to hide under the back deck.
Yeah.
I'd rather sit under the back deck, and one of my boys would get the pamphlet,
the homily? Whatever the itinerary is.
Yeah,
for
the
mass.
Itinerary, because it had a certain time on it. So you told your mom you're going to 10 a.m. at mass. You got to come home with a 10 a.m. I fucking forget the name.
Your mom wouldn't go either?
My mom would go, but she'd go in different hours because she was a nurse. So sometimes she would go Saturday night, get it out. She was the only one that was Catholic, like truly Catholic. She still goes to church. She was a Eucharistic minister and said she was pursuing other religions.
Really?
Yeah.
She's polyamorous.
She's poly, Yeah, she's polyreligious.
What's a Eucharistic?
She had to tell someone Eucharistic minister, you get like, it's like marrying somebody, I guess. It's like you can hand off the Eucharist to all the fucking vampire parishioners.
What's a Eucharist?
Eucharist is the body of Christ.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. It's a little wafer.
Why are you
the Jesus? You never heard of Eucharist?
We didn't call it Eucharist.
What'd you call it?
Jesus bread.
It's truly a Jesus.
A God loaf.
Wait, did you go to like a fun church? Were they like playing jazz music or something?
No, they it was very traditional. And one time the youth group, they played like Christian rock. And some of the older members got mad that they were playing rock music.
Too hardcore?
Yeah, too hardcore versus the hymns.
How'd you get into this?
Into what?
I don't know. Anything entertaining?
Yeah.
Life?
Through my dad. We did theater stuff growing up. I did plays at the local theater guild.
Oh, I thought it was going to be through the church.
We did a little bit of that.
Every church has like a silo for gays. Every church I went to. Yeah, it is. They like they have a theater program that's like so gay people can keep going to church.
Right.
Never.
At least that's what that's the ones I went to. They always had
No, the silo program was become a deacon.
That's a different silo.
Yeah. The ultimate silo.
Yeah.
This abstaining from women's easy.
I never trusted a deacon. I wasn't sure. I was like, why are you here? You can have a family. You can have sex with women. I mean, I actually kind of respect that more. What do you think the percentages of priesthood that are actually dedicated to Christ and really want to spread the good word?
versus just wanting to get their load off and a bunch of kids.
Yeah. Or just, yeah, cheat the system in whatever maniacal, perverted way.
I don't know. I didn't know these guys very well, but all my, like, priests and stuff seemed just like dudes. Like, it seemed like there was something they were like.
Were they cool?
I wouldn't go that far, but they just seemed like regular guys. Like, they weren't. Yeah, they didn't seem crazy or
didn't
weird.
Didn't seem off or creepy.
Like, no, they were just like, it almost seemed like a thing they were doing for a while. It was always interesting to me when you got a new priest. It was like, where did this guy come from? What happened in the
last?
You know
what happened. He got transferred after diddling.
No. But it would be like a guy who just came out of the seminary.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
It's just like, the whole thing was like fascinating
yeah.
to me.
You don't want that, too.
You got
that's
a degree.
That's like SportsCenter hiring a new newscaster.
Yeah.
You're like, I don't have the emotional capacity to start to love this person because I already have my four.
Yeah, and no one was talking about the new guy.
Come on.
They'd just be like, all right, now this guy's talking to us. No one, I didn't approve this.
Yeah. Run it by the eighth graders before you bring in Father Ferentz.
True.
This is a very weird episode.
I don't know. I'm kind of liking it.
We had.
Did you fuck around in church? Well, that's why I
was
going,
so scared.
My
so
and
I was so scared to sin because hell is such a scary thing. Like, I didn't say any cuss words until ninth grade, and it was like a conscious decision. It's like, I'm gonna start cussing now.
Yeah,
because I always said like effin' and frick.
Did you say it into your pillow first or something?
Yeah, I remember I told my friends I sang along to
I can't tell if he's doing a thing.
Get low like by the East Side Boys. Lil Jon and the East Side Boys. I remember I would
get
always
low,
sing
get
that.
Low, get,
yeah. To the window, to the wall, to the sweatshop,
you said balls,
down my
was
ball.
Your first one?
I would say balls, yeah. Oh, skeet, skeet, ma. And I'd go effer. Oh, skeet, skeet, ma, effer.
Oh, skeet. You'd sing this out loud?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, skeet, skeet, gosh darn.
Now, that's cute when you're like 7.
Yeah, but I was, yeah.
15.
I was 15, yeah.
What are all your friends doing the shit?
It was like half and half, and then some of them would cuss, and I would get like mad at them. I was such a little bitch.
Oh, my
I'd be like,
God.
You shouldn't cuss.
No,
you shouldn't do like hand stuff with
were
your
there
girlfriend.
Were there any like street kids? What about kids that like fucking revolted? Like there was no like pill heads or like.
Oh,
like,
there was.
Kids?
I had a gay friend who he came out, and that was one of the reasons. Because whenever he came out, I was like, oh, fuck, Jackson's going to hell. That sucks, man. That sucks.
I started to really like Jackson.
Yeah. And then he, I remember it was me, him, and another friend. We all promised to never smoke weed together. We would say we would never do drugs, never drink anything. But then.
They make you do that, I feel like.
No, we did that just on our own.
No, I know, but it's in there. To
yeah,
like
it's in
bond
there.
Up and make promises about things you won't do.
Mm-hmm.
It's like weird.
Keep each other accountable.
Yeah. It's spooky.
Yeah, I'm so glad I wasn't like in a sect like that. Whereas like Catholic school in a city suburb is like, look, we didn't want you going to the public school.
Yeah, well, it's also
it's not
just
crazy.
Like,
yeah. Outside of the curriculum, learning religion for 12 years is insane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's insane.
Mm-hmm.
I would have rather gone to public school, but my mom thought it was like dangerous.
Dude, there's too many older brothers. I mean, that was like I don't remember going to church and not having my brother be like, this is bullshit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All this is bullshit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just so you know.
The annoying thing with religion, at least in my experience, it's with Christianity, it's always the biggest lessons are always things that you aren't supposed to do. There's not a lot of focus on things that you should do. It's always what are you doing that you should feel really bad about?
Yeah.
So just as a kid, it was always shame and guilt and feeling like I was going to hell.
My brother told me God wasn't real in third grade.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, I don't even think
he
I
was
it
in
that
sixth.
Far. Yeah.
It's
Whoa.
Like our whole life was going to church during school and then on Sundays. I wore a uniform for the first 13 years of my life.
That's crazy. Kind of sick.
I'm sorry, 18.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like fucking till I was 18 years old. I'm sorry. Yeah, 18.
Mm-hmm.
A shirt and tie. In the summer, you had to wear a sweater. So we made Dickies. We cut the dress shirt from here to here like the priests have.
Yeah, yeah.
You just put a collar and then an over top. Mm-hmm.
Nice.
You know?
That's pretty, how, like a bib.
It was a bib. Mm-hmm. And then your tie would just hang over your belly button. So all my boys, we get changed for like baseball practice and everybody would take their sweater off and then everyone's wearing a bib.
But you had like, to wear the sweater in the heat?
All the way until you could finally switch off to a short sleeve shirt. But, you know, Philadelphia, that this summer's and spring and summer, you never know what 2 weeks are going to get shifted.
Yeah, yeah.
You sweat your dick off. They're like, not yet. It's not the start of summer.
Damn, I hated God so much.
Yeah.
I hated him so much.
What'd he do to you?
I think it was more just I didn't like going to church.
Yeah.
And I felt like he was responsible. Yeah.
Yes.
So then I was like, fuck this guy. He's not mm-hmm. real. He's mm-hmm. a piece of shit.
Yeah, he's getting me out of bed.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I could be watching cartoons. I could be playing in the yard.
See,
I could
this language, if he was 13 and you were saying this language, he would be on fire right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
Yeah. You'd be yeah. pissed off.
Yeah.
Were your parents, they were obviously super hardcore religious, but did they believe yeah. it or were they just...
Yeah, they did. My dad doesn't. I don't know if my mom does right now, but I think he's pulling her to... It's weird because my dad and her still go to church because he sings in the choir.
Oh, that's kind of fun.
He loves performing, and he loves it.
Not a lot of gigs.
No, there aren't.
A lot of gigs in East Tennessee. Yeah.
You have to be religious to perform.
That's so funny. Does he have to show up for church just to perform?
Yeah.
He's got to pay his dues?
Yeah. Yeah, but he likes it. He likes the community of it.
Yeah. Yeah. He just took the edge off a bit, going, yeah, I'm not going to...
Yeah,
I'm not going to get crazy.
Yeah.
I'm not going to learn Ezekiel 3:5.
Yeah.
I've been saying this for a while. I feel like I want to go back to church every Sunday.
Yeah?
Yeah, just to see what's going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can tell you what's going on right now.
I want to see what's...
I can reenact exactly
what they're talking about.
Yeah. I want to go to a mega church like a Joel's.
That would be fun. Uh-huh. To see what these fucking maniacs...
I want to go
maniacs.
To the locals. I want to go... I got it. I get it. It's a big old grift or whatever.
I feel like we're just avoiding the obvious. We want to go to a black church.
No, no.
It's the only thing that's
interesting. No, he doesn't want to at all.
That's one thing I do not want to do.
Oh, my God. I went once. It's fucking incredible.
Yeah, dancing.
A small black church in North Philly. It was unbelievable.
Yeah.
They're so welcoming. There's a barbecue afterwards. It was crazy.
They bring you into the fold, or they?
Of course they
or
did.
Or they know you're there just to watch
no. I was
the show.
I was being genuine. I was interested in seeing how the culture behaves at church. Yeah.
Did they give you a fan?
There was actually. That's a great question. I don't think it was that hot that season. I would have waited until the next year. No, but it was wild. It's exactly how you imagine. There was no microphone. A small like creaky
yeah.
wooden church. Dancing the whole fucking time. The sermon was insane.
What are they talking about?
Oh, they just pick a lesson out of the Bible and then riff.
Yeah.
This guy was amazing. Of course he had like a Lexus.
See, that's what I want. I want to see what the homilies are.
He was a pastor. He wasn't a priest. He was like
yeah.
a man of the community who just
yeah.
robs
talking
from
about stuff that was
religious
going on.
People.
Yeah.
Pastors are criminals. They're absolutely criminals.
They're trying to be.
They prey on the weak-minded.
They're trying to be. They're trying to get the big.
I mean, if this wasn't on camera, I would say, like, if we could do one. If I had hit the lottery, I would pretend to be like Mace, and I would just be a pastor and see how large I can get my church.
Yeah. Yeah, just
you know,
do it.
As a study?
Yeah.
Like, how good
that is
my sermons and how entertaining my sermons can be.
Oh, you get the. You have to have a lot of programs for the kids because then it's like free babysitting for the parents, yeah. and that gets the families in there.
I got money to hire a fucking.
I'm sure they have
Wrangler.
That. Yeah, in the same
way,
there's like
all you need is a basketball court.
Sure,
and
that's big.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. My gym
that's
has
it.
Location, location, location. It is, I'm sure there are like conferences and seminars. Like people go if they're like trying to start like a dental practice, they go to like a place where people mm-hmm. tell you how to like set it up.
Yeah.
I'm sure there's the same thing with a church. And I'm sure they have all you want a basketball court, you want a jungle gym.
Yeah.
You need to be babysitting these kids.
Yeah.
And then you get the money. And then
is
you,
it like if you want to start
power.
Like a
then
you
get,
then
the,
you
khakis,
get the money
yeah.
and then you get the
is
power.
It like a franchise where you like I want to start a Methodist church? I have to like if you're starting a Chick-fil-A restaurant, you have to pay them money. Do you have to pay money to some big Methodist group if you want your church to be branded as Methodist?
Oh, there's no way that those big ones aren't franchised in some way, like Billy Graham, and they've got to be like, and like you pay.
You mean
us,
there's a pyramid?
Yeah, well, you pay us, we endorse your fucking church, and then you like become part of our little program. And
like, could I
the Billy
start
Graham
one?
Fans in your area will go to your church?
Yeah.
Right?
Could I just start one? Just open up one and be like, "This is the true Church of Mormon."
Yeah. Mormon, yeah, you could do that.
Mormonology.
Yeah.
I think you just
yeah.
you know, yeah,
you could be Mormon. You could you could splint. You could create a new sect any day.
You
right?
just fill out a government doc.
Yeah,
because then you're tax free.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. that's
and you
the big
be
thing.
Like, it's Mormonism, but we believe this.
Isn't
other
the mothership
stuff.
A church?
Mm-hmm.
Joe's not paying any taxes. That
no,
be
I
sick
think that
to
was
set up
the
a
other
comedy
one.
Club. That's just a church.
Yeah, I remember I did a show in Colorado, in Colorado Springs, where it was a weed church. They were just like selling weed, but they were also a church, so they were like tax free.
That's
no.
crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. I think you can start a church.
Technically anywhere.
Doing anything. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know what the requirements are, but.
Yeah.
It's a great idea.
I think
for...
they're pretty, like, I don't think it's a heavy lift.
Dude, you could just set up a church, do a live podcast at the church
yeah.
every Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
That's your podcast. But it's not about anything church related.
Yeah.
So you get everybody in there, you get money, no taxes, you got a place to do stand up.
Could you just say this is a church service?
You could, yeah.
We need to get 1,000 people in there.
I don't think so. I don't think it's based on ticket sales.
I'm saying it is for us. We're trying to make some money here, dude. My fake church idea.
Nick, you just need to be evangelizing somehow.
Yeah.
The theme of the podcast is we bring one person in a week. And we
rape them.
Just a guy who's confused about what churches do.
You got two options. You can either sign up or you get fucked in.
Yeah. I think it could work.
It will work. Do you have anything to plug?
We're Absolute Show. It's live comedy talk show.
I did it. It was fucking fun as hell.
Tommy did it. Chris did it.
I did do. It was great.
They both did fantastic. One of them did better. I won't say which one. But it's now at the Creek and Cave every Wednesday at 8 p.m. It's also on YouTube, Absolute Show.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Lukas McCrary. We'll drop his handle in this stuff.
Yeah.
You got anything to plug?
No, I'm plugging that I'm here now.
Yeah, we're in Texas.
Fucking amazing.
We're living in. So this is what you need. You need to draft your church bylaws and belief statement.
Yeah.
Structure and name the church. That's easy.
Yeah.
Get a 501c3 status.
Easy.
That feels like it might be tough. That's paperwork. Get an employer identification number. Open a bank account. That seems odd.
We can have a stuff filing church.
Yeah.
We have an employer identification number. We're an LLC. We've just changed that to a 503. I'm dead serious. I'm going to look into this.
Yeah, it would be a fun thing to do.
You can just rent out a property until you can buy it off.
I don't think you'd need a property, even.
Just do a live podcast once a week?
Because a church is where you make it.
Where you congregate.
Yeah. A church is where the people are. It's not about walls.
True.
That's one thing I learned.
I was going to say that's a very learned statement.
Yeah.
Spiritual.
Yeah. Do you need an address to start a church? That'd be fucked up.
Use my parents. Still getting my mail.
My bedroom, my house. My childhood bedroom is my church.
My mom still calls me about like TD Bank statements.
All of my Michael Jordan posters.
I haven't had a fucking TD Bank in 15 years, Mom. Throw it out.
My pastor once, I couldn't tell if he was being like super, I couldn't tell if he was being racist or like super progressive. In the sermon, he was talking about how he went to a prison to preach. And he said, and of course at the prison, it was all black people. And then he just moved on.
Choose your next sentence very carefully. Very carefully.